Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. We are back with the Drake series, so smash that like button for Drake and Future and everything that Drake's been putting out. It's a tremendous. Today we're going to get into his trap soul style. We've trained over 600,000 producers around the world, and I want to help more producers today, so smash that like button. It really does help. And subscribe if you're new. So I'll be quick about this and straightforward. We want some kind of retro synth. So I'm going to use the ARP 2600 for the sound. I have a pre-made sound in here. You can go through any preset. Just pick one that works because we're going to be changing them anyway. So grab a preset and let's start with the melody. Now, on my melody, I also have Valhalla Shimmer. This is going to be key to the sound, but I'm going to turn it off for now so we don't kind of hear it yet. Let's right click, go to piano roll, and let's just start on a random note. And think of it like an arpeggio, but kind of playing chords. So whatever you want to play, again, there's no rules to this. We're at 160 BPM. So I'm using a half step to keep it kind of trap. And again, it will sound different once we're done. Now don't be afraid to harmonize your notes here. So you can add a fifth, which is E to B. There's a lot of things you could do, okay, with melody. So I'm just going to harmonize it with the fifth here. We probably don't need to harmonize every note. So think of it like a Playboy Cardi kind of loop. Just keep looping it until it sounds how you want it. But again, you could split up chords. You could do a lot of things. Harmonic intervals, whatever you want to do. So we're in C sharp minor, by the way, the key. If you don't know what the key is, I mapped it out on scalar. So it's these notes, G sharp, A, B, C sharp, D sharp, E, G sharp. Okay, so you could change one note here and there. A quick little thing is just take out that first note. Okay, now let's add Valhalla Shimmer. This is gonna give it its body. I just have the mix really high and just turn the shift down if you want. So this fills out the sound. Let's pull it up and down an octave. It's too high. And now let's go through the presets. Now before we get to the presets, let's hear what halftime would sound like. I don't think we need halftime, but it's always good to check. I think if you did have halftime, you would have to halftime the whole thing, not just like blending it in for this sound. Also, don't forget you can reverse melodies, but we're not there yet. So let's just go through presets. So if you don't have my preset, then that's fine. I'm not giving out the preset. I probably did one project file somewhere, but there's no download for it that I know of. So in that case, let's use some factory presets. Now we definitely want to stay away from saw sounds. This sounds dope. I forgot we're in halftime. Now again, modern sounds don't use these bright kind of synths that they used to use in the 70s. So anything that's super bright, if you don't know how to add a filter to it, I would just add an EQ filter. Because this hardware is super complicated in person. I've seen a variation of this, not this 2600, I think it was like a 2400 or something, but they're complicated in person. So instead of trying to figure out how to do a low pass filter, you could just override it, is what I'm trying to say. Even though it's kind of bitey, I like the sound. It just has like a something to it. So let's add a low pass filter to it. You just grab an EQ. Let's cut out some of those super lows. And that shimmer kind of takes, like here's without the shimmer. Still sounds good, but the shimmer just adds that blurriness that we need. And again, let's reverse this, see what it sounds like. Now, what you would do, again, I have to do this different for the video because it's recording the audio and it will mess up the thing. But you would right click, consolidate this track from track start, and then it would convert this into audio. I have to do it a different way, recording into Edison. Let's record on play. Okay, let's hear what this sounds like in reverse. There's no guarantees it's gonna sound good. Just double click your song jump, send it to audio. Send it to the playlist as an audio clip. Okay, it took a little bit. Let's go to our channel settings and just hit reverse. And then go to song mode and let's hear it. You can't even really tell it's in reverse because of the sound selection, but just, you always want to try it. It may make it sound cooler, but you never know. Or, I forgot, let's undo some of that. Let's also, and tongue twist it because my brain is going 1,000 miles an hour and my mouth's trying to catch up. Go to time stretch mode and just left click and drag it out. This is also something you can test. Go to stretch mode. But that's kind of like an atmosphere drone sound. You can use that for filler, but... Oh, you know what? It's also running through the effects. I forgot. Let's just keep swapping out the sound. You don't have to use this plugin either. Just anything with a synth bell would work. I like this. Also, like with halftime, so here's what I'll do. Create an automation clip for the mix level of halftime and just copy your melody and turn your automation off in the beginning. Just left click, right click to add a dot and just turn it on. Or you can blend it 50%, whatever you want. So it feels like two different sections. It feels also like a Lil Uzi Vert lane because of the game-like sound. But let's definitely flip this into a trap soul. Let's open up the filter maybe. Let's try it. Nah, it's too bright if you open up the filter. Let's grab some trap drums from BusyWorksBeats.com and the X kit. Let's grab some kicks. Where are we at? Kick IH always works. I already grabbed that. And there's an open hi-hat I want in the hi-hats folder called C3. Let's grab that. We need a snare. I'm gonna use this Drake snare here. Map these out. It's more of like an 80s bass snare. We're gonna use it to bounce. Just gonna shorten it out a little bit. Also, you can shorten this out if you want. There's a lot going on here, but let's just keep. Don't be afraid to crank your snares and your kicks either. So here's the trap part. Let's create our kicks. Again, the kick, crank it up. Go to your wrench tool, crank up the volume. I add a Fruity Soft Clipper to my master track so it doesn't clip. You could probably do it on the actual track too, so it doesn't clip. Let's just make this a little longer, have a couple variations. Rarely do I add my hi-hats on the same track, but in this case I want to visually see the open hi-hat. tuning the percussion here. Okay, we need high hats to keep it moving. Very subtle. Again, I usually don't draw all my hi-hats on the same track, but in this case, and when the kick distorts the whole track, it sizzles up the hi-hats as well. Is, do we want 808s or do we want like a synth bass? Let's use an 808. Let me go to my best friend Jacob's folder. He has an 808 in here that's pretty dope. Might not work for this track though. Use 808 dungeon, just normalize it. Play it by hand, but I also want to try some techniques. So let's get the tone right. I'm going to make sure the kick overlaps the 808. So I'm turning on the hold parameter, then you can hit Shift D to make everything the same length and just hit Control A and just left click and drag the note however long you want. Now in that case, these overlap, so you would hit Alt-L. Actually, I don't like that sound. I was trying it out, but I don't like it. I'm just gonna let the 808 ring out with the release tail. track, so the 808s would not come in right away. Then you just add a trap soul idea to it. To control G, double click on the pattern. Let's just get rid of the kick to control X. That way you have a buildup. So again, there's a lot of mixing involved here. When like that decap sound, you could distort it more, you could do a lot of stuff. We're not gonna get into mixing because it takes up too much time. And where are we at? Cooper time cue. So in this case, we're gonna use the Haas effect to widen the 808. Like melody in here, you have enough room for it, but the vocal melody is the main thing. So hit that thumbs up. If you want more of this series, the artist series right here, busyworksbeats.com. Thanks for watching. Please hit that like button and subscribe if you're new. It's busyworksbeats.com.